but it's well respected.
It's Tails.
A well respected OG. You're going
right into this shit.
We live
over
here.
Don't worry about it.
What?
All right, you do that one.
What do you mean? You just did the
coin toss.
You go first, bro.
You deserve it.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah, yeah.
One more.
Come on.
You better come with some fucking bars. I wanna hear no fucking excuses when this shit's fucking over. No excuses, but this is your chance to fucking prove yourself, fucking hell. I can be able to kill you in 6 months this year. You'll find out the status of the business. It can't be changed since.
YouTube.com/GroundZeroBattles. Hit me up on Twitter at GullyTK if you want to get King of the Dot Hob.
What's good? It's your boy Christian 818 the Gatekeeper. Motherfucking scums of the earth crew. I'm gonna shout out to the Elephant Graveyard, Doorway Bars, Hip Hop Canada, Best Revival, Epic Project, Mike Masters Alliance, and Basement 818, Fresh Coast. We active, baby!
My name's Lush One, and I ain't gonna lie to y'all, I still can't feel my face.
Yeah! I want some!
Famous DJ Ski, we out here rapping for the West Coast.
Yes.
Greatest battle ever. Let's go.
Best Stop Brooklyn is still in here. We repping that battle lifestyle. We repping good battles.
Yes.
My name is Poison Pen. PoisonPen.tv. URLTV.tv. The biggest battle. King of the Dot. And yeah, make some fucking noise. Yeah. Yeah.
That being said, rapper to my right, introduce yourself.
Whip the Jack Alive and direct live on set.
the legendary clothing. I am king. Trap house. Leroy's in store clothes. Walk-in closet. Yo, check it out. And a special shout out to my little cousin Mason. It's his birthday.
Disaster when the coin toss. It is on the homie cannabis. Let's fucking go. King of the guy.
Praise Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Those look like Tom Cruise mom shoes. Soaked in some nasty ass wonton soup. You about to lose. What you got to prove? Yeah? Who you gonna wrap circles around? Turn around, cause you ain't allowed to worship the crown. You look like a dead bird on the ground, with your bones exposed. This is your funeral services now. This is your death, Diz. Pour it out, pass it around. I laugh at your style. The wise owl laughs at the crowd. Pound for pound, I clip your wings, lift your ass off the ground. Throw you in the air, crash you in the clouds. What the fuck is you talking about? I brought enough rhymes to snuff all four of them out. I bet you hang out with Elton John in Lebanon when Eminem's gone, so both of y'all can make feminine bars. You must be smoking hope in an opium pipe if you think you're gonna win tonight. Yeah, right. These people came to see a fight.
Yeah!
I'ma fuck you up in this battle royale. Yeah, dawg. I'ma make you not ever wanna rap no more. Cause you cheating. You know you in agreement with demons, you sucking semen. You really think that's air that you breathing? Dirty fucking scumbag, trash bag of scum. You look like a vampire that drinks faggot blood. And you gonna catch that fade, baby. The streets is watching like Jay-Z. I squeeze your IV till you sit up and face me. You crazy. Your EKG beeping like you lazy. Fuck you, pay me, or donate it to Haiti. To be here today, I had to hypnotize myself. But it's impossible to lie to myself. Look at him. It's like I'm standing beside myself. He bit my whole fucking staff. I got MMA niggas in the crowd. I should make them whip your ass right now. Hey yo, hood niggas. What's good, nigga? Wing nuts. Batter you in the woods around trees and ninjas. Battle rap 20 degrees colder in the winter. In the summer, I'm Sizzler. Roll you up like Rizzlers. Toss you 1,000 bars, nigga, tell you to bench it. Then I batter you again just to see if you meant it. Look at the people on the rooftop, the people on the fences. You came here healthy, you gon' leave here injured. Real gladiators gotta bleed in the trenches. Go ahead, Diz. Do your famous Slim Shady impression. Bring 5-9 in the session, I teach the three of you a lesson. I spit real rap shit. You pop shit, no question. Disaster and his fans is a bunch of bitches. You know I'm hardcore, I showed up with stitches. Come on, Diz. Now you know you went over your head. When there's people in the crowd that memorize battle rhymes, I said, I batter you in the flesh, I batter you on the neck, I batter you over the phone. I batter you standing leaning over the toilet with my dick out. Batty, you juggling a hand grenade with the pin out. In a stolen car with the VIN number ripped out. Drinking a Guinness stout, doing a... You already know. I look like Riddick out the slam. You an Arabic Peter Pan looking out for the clan. Come on, fam. You know the big bad wolf eat the lamb. I'm a tiger with infinite stripes. You two can't stand. Damn. You know cocaine's a hell of a drug. Made this dumb fuck wanna battle Ken I Brook. I told this nigga. I'm taking your ass to Disneyland. I'ma piss in your mouth while you shit in your pants. My fans gonna shit on your fans. I'm glad you a battle thug. The big bad wolf gonna drink a glass of your blood. I use his skin for a fucking prayer rug. I destroy you. I hated you the first time I saw you. Motherfuckers like you get buried for being loyal. I'm ashamed of hip hop for even praising you. You don't exist before YouTube, cause you ain't really paid no dues. Get respect for saying stupid shit. Your fans are clueless. They think you got juice and shit.
Okay. All right, let's go.
Every time you in Atlanta, Eddie Long is your pastor.
Traitor,
a fake gold jewelry chain maker, a slumdog millionaire's neighbor. I'm a Jamaican assassin. You a disaster waiting to happen. You couldn't fight your way out of a wet paper napkin. I jumped out my mama pussy. You fell out your mother booty all wiggly, covered in hummus, all filthy. Yo, I'ma let the world know the truth. You don't want me to shine, you study my rhyme. Then you laid your vocals at the mine. That's a bitch move, something that disaster would do. You say you the best battle in the world, you ain't telling the truth. You study my background, ain't no book that I wrote. Ain't no footnotes, your whole style's one big joke. From DNA to Arsenal to KOTD, now you wanna fuck with me? You must be crazy. I'm an apex predator. You a battle rap degenerate, trying to gain leverage from a high fructose beverage.
Yo!
Yeah!
acting for me, today think the reversal of that. Today every single verse that I rap is gonna have zero personal attacks. I'ma use the science and math and shit that you teach, and I'm gonna murk you with that. No personals, no jokes, just lyricism, cause hip hop has always been like that. So anything he says to me intellectual, I'ma be able to flip right back. I can teach y'all how to chemically break down an enzyme flat, stabilize the temperature using incubators, which condense molecules that turns into H2O, you can get right back. Stabilize the temperature using incubators that condense molecules into H2O, you can get right back. Cause when particles... Wait a minute, y'all thought I was gonna come out here and spit some stupid shit like that! Hey, yo! Let me get this fucking word off! Fucking faggot brought all of his homies with him! He hasn't even got his verse off and this little fucking homo already got his shirt off! You wanna sit the bell, you get killed, and sit the bell, you fucking pussy! You probably paint your pinky nails and chill with him at Chippendales! Welcome to hell, Jermaine, the wrath is coming! Yeah. This is the part of the rap, you get your ass confronted, then I catch you in the back end, relaxed and blunted, and set the place on fire, till it feels like you're sitting inside of a dragon's stomach! You cats don't want it, you get castrated, okay. And hack the nuggets, I make chicken strips out of your loved ones, okay. That's why I call it family bucket! I'm like KFC when I pull the axe out. You get slashed and gutted so fast, even the king of the dot staff when he panoramic camera coverage just to capture the angle of the blood back from the other side of the room when I drag you from it. Fucking yelling over my shit like they always do. That's some shit I already knew. What's wrong with you, cannabis? What is you fucked up doing some skateboarding stuff? I'm trying to figure out how you ended up with your bones getting crushed. But now it makes sense. I get it. You punched yourself in the chest so hard you made your own shoulders touch. Grace fell a long way from the praise that he's gotten to being strayed, misplaced, and forgotten. Nowadays, from place to place, he be hopping, but he never feels safe. No matter where he's at, from all the names he be dropping, and he keeps dropping names even after all the pain that it cost him. He stays taking losses. LL Cool J basically stomped him. The same happened with Slim Shady, even though you initiated the problem. So it's safe to say after today, this will be the nail in his coffin. Skills. Even if you took millions and millions of pills like the kid from the film Limitless, you still couldn't think of shit that's this ill. Ill, ridiculous, chill. You physically bit like a little bitch. You squat tripping and they all getting killed. You dogs, I'm skinning them, knitting them into a sweater quicker than Cruella DeVille. I'm ill. Look at this fucking treatment I'm giving them. Look at the treatment I'm giving this old ass senior citizen that wouldn't be seen within the reach of 300 feet of the streets of Michigan from all the nightmares and dreams of Slim repeatedly ripping him. Peter Griffin, so why do I beef with this chicken? Jabbing and kicking repeatedly till he bleeds from his ribs and then falls asleep in the concrete in the same fetal position he was left him in ever since Eminem beat his career in submission and didn't let him spit again. Blackballed, and restricted him, blocked him from his mission or any other business attempt. So technically Slim ended up stiffing him harder than he did to Kim ever since the last time the bitch attempted taking half of his shit from him. Miserable type sucker. You lived in a time cluster. Well, it was easy for getting by because most of the industry lines were missing those intricate rhyme structures. So your lyrics to them were like mind fuckers. But as the internet lines buffered, you realize it's harder to keep up with these little guys because it's like a million times tougher. I mean, looking at him, I feel like the universe just wants to witness this guy suffer because he's going through hell and LL's out in some ridiculous price suburb. He probably lives with a white butler who every night is hired to fix him a nice supper. He literally drives like 65 Hummers and each one of them is specifically a different type of color. Y'all know what rhymes with Jermaine Williams? Never been to you. That's what
brilliant! That dude, I don't know who he is, but he's straight brilliant! Exactly. Nothing happened. There was no one left on Earth for cannabis to call out, so we pretty much ran out of things to talk about. The industry blocked him out, and they fucking locked him out. You didn't hear from him again until he popped up in a song calling out every single member from Slaughterhouse. You would have socked every one of them out. Don't be mad at them because he took the hater slash salty route. Motherfucker, everybody hates your guts. You called everybody out from Slaughterhouse except Cook and I, because Cook and I would have stomped you out. Bro, everybody fucking hates you. Everybody hates you. What the fuck? Everybody hates you. What the fuck are you talking about? We interviewed LL and even his own mama said to knock you out. Look at the bright side. You're like a certified author now. You can write a novel on what being blackballed is all about. It's probably all them call-outs and them blogs, but why he had a falling out. It's like being inside of a pool hall watching his ass fall because he got 8 blackballed and then they chalked him out. What the fuck are you talking about?
What?
We all miss that cannabis that used to attack that first wave. Stabbing birth like an animal that's trapped in a dirt cage. Nowadays, you uninspired and I can see the cracks in the wordplay. What you saying, oh, I kept it true to hip-hop, blah, 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 blah. That's what the hurt say. You took your ball home and went home because things in the industry weren't happening your way. You wanted to become famous too. You and LL were supposed to collab on the first take, but he body-bagged you off the track in the worst way. Then you came back and you said it wasn't about the fame. It's about being heard and there's a purpose to every actual verse made, but that's the impact that accurate words make, because if it was truly about the love for the art and the lab is your workplace, then you would have never wanted to be on a track like that in the first place. Fuck out of here. People try to go mainstream and they flip-flop and then they try to disguise their failure as them being true to hip-hop. So I don't give a fuck what you gotta talk about. Next time one of your homies pops out, that's how you do a fucking first-round knockout.
Fucking Iranian shoe bombing, Islamic Matt Hoffman, Jewish Bron Solomon, in Jesus Christ's name, amen. Separated shoulder, crawling out of Border Patrol. I ain't have enough quarters for the toll. $300 bounty. It took 10 days before I got out the county. They was fighting all around me. This is how they found me. I came here to do you worse than DNA did. I wanted it to be no more wins for you in this battle rap biz. I wanted to eat your fucking heart 2 chambers at a time. Cause maybe after that you understand the danger of the rhyme. Gravity is a repulsion, not an attraction. When it comes to lyrics, I used to be the living Bruce Lee in action. Counter psychological measures reduce the pressure. Who's better? That motherfucker? Never.
Yeah.
It's gonna take a lot more than him to make Ken I bust a believer. Man, I thought you was gonna walk out with Justin Bieber. I never met a battler to act like Stan so much. He wanna be Marshall so bad, he put up bread to battle Ken I bust.
Ken I bust.
Tell him, you hang out with Elton John in Lebanon when Eminem's gone, so both of y'all can massage RuPaul's balls. Are you a faggot or a faggot magnet? Why the fuck are you so obsessed with eating rappers' asses? What are you, disaster? Are you an Armenian monkey trainer? A Middle Eastern gospel country singer? Or a hot urine drinking camel kissing sand nigga? Is that in your rostomy bag? Come here, let me talk to you, man. Somebody strip search this terrorist fat. That's right, I smell the fear. Somewhere in here and up there, I seen the piss running down the stairs.
Yeah. Go ahead, go ahead.
My niggas' pauses are epic.
I bet you in your whole life, you never even cleaned one weapon. You play Call of Duty and do Scarface impressions. Chill, brethren. Real G's come out to see the legends. Nobody gives a shit about the honorable mentions.
Yep.
If I catch him levitating, I'm devastating. I'll shave him and suffocate him, then bring him back to life to interrogate him. You fucking pagan, what I told you about meditating? What the fuck is a Canadian Arabian? I'm Rip the Jacker, the White Chapel Black Battler. Say it faster, disaster is a punchline amateur.
You're a bro.
Let's go. Okay.
What else? Hit him.
Hey, boy.
You can't even ride a beat. Get your bitch ass off the street. Your bitch ass should be across the street. Talk is cheap. Till a lyrical metal jacket lift you off your feet. I've been the goddamn acapella chief all week. When I'm done with you, you gon' be rapping in China. Somewhere with no running water, battling minors with fresh coast tinnitus and a fresh slice of fresh coast hepatitis. You a pedophile that bites vaginas. In a dark room, eating mosquitoes, flies, and spiders. About to get waterboarded, hooked up to two wires. The crowd say ooh, the crowd say ah. Unlimited rounds, you must be in the mood to die. Mama say, mama sa, mama kusa. I put a tattoo of you on Tretch right next to Tupac.
You pathetic faggot. I will stomp you to death. I'm a fucking hustler, so when I be calling people, you know, I call to collect. But when Cannabis be calling people, you know, he be calling collect. See, you want to talk that talk out here, just deposit the check, because if not, I'm going to fucking stomp you to death. See, out in the East, you can talk that talk, but if you talk that talk in the West, you leave like Flavor Flav, just another skinny little black faggot getting clocked in his chest. Then he said I'm like Slim Shady. I'm trying to be Slim Shady. Just for saying that, you're gonna end up demolishing yourself. Bro, that whole part you were talking about, I don't know if you were referring to me or talking about yourself. Cause there ain't nothing worse in the world than that track that you did with Stan. What was it, the four horses you guys got back together back in Scribble Jam, or was it that, the Rap Olympics fam? Either way, nobody fucking gives a damn. Hey, listen, bro. I pull it out and I snap and click and bam, kinda like my gat already had an app for Instagram. This motherfucker wants to take my ass to Disneyland. Sorry, Dad, I'ma scratch that because I have a different plan. How about I take you to the ranch in Neverland and put you in a casket quicker than 1,000 milligrams of Michael Jackson's Diprovan? Oh! motherfucker thought he was gonna come back and kill me, man. This motherfucking cannabis sucks. Besides, all it took back in the day was two L's and a Cool J to roll cannabis up. And since we in Cali, I'ma put magazines in them. That's what I call a cannabis cop. But I'm just clowning with you. You obviously a mark. Don't make this clown shit an issue. I'll rip your body apart. I'll fire rounds from the pistol. My shells are like the red ones from Mario Kart because they follow you around till they hit you. My guns gonna feel like a merry-go-round once they get you because they gonna lift you four horsies off of the ground and then spin you. Oh, that's some crazy shit whenever you reach the top. Let's say right now you can fucking take me on. Yeah, I've already got this region locked, bro. I am the king of the dot. You... Let me teach you something, bro. Let me teach you how to keep the spot because you couldn't because your value in it would decrease the stock of it. This ain't 2000 BC. I guess he forgot. Motherfucker, you shouldn't even talk. His old ass is probably still sitting here waiting for the beat to drop. Hey, yo, you're not even sharp. At least not enough for me, not enough for this league. I mean, what good is marching on soft sand when you don't have strong enough feet to walk on concrete and your schemes are not built up to par with the top tiers we got? Man, you should take it a little easy, Pops, because you're getting a little old and out here people speed a lot. Let me tell you, proceed with caution. There ain't no beat in this arena to cover up your cheesy bars. I can visibly see your flaws, allowing me to use them as a weakness that I'm feeding off. But the leading cause of beef that's caused between us is a missing link of not being able to think or ever be evolved. See, it's easy to see why he dissolved, because he's a subspecies. So even though everything we're taught to believe revolves around us being engineered human beings, we're clearly not, because seeing people like him breathing are the real reason I don't believe in God. And if there's like a 1 in 6 billion chance that my theory's wrong, I put my cheese up on it that this idiot would completely defeat the odds. You ain't a thief that robs people because you're evil, dog. You a thief that robs people because you need a job. You want to eat? Then I'll beat you over the head with a piece of beef kebab and let you bleed across the street from Ross, the same place you faggots buy your t-shirts off. Homie, I will kill you as soon as the fucking needle drops. Run outside and have my homies let the heater off and blood will be filling up the street like it was cedar block. Yeah. You're not strong enough to top your peak. Just face it, you've aged and you've gotten weak. You could no longer keep up pace with today's top elites, not a cappella or on the beat. Just stop blogging, please, if not at least while you still got a spot to keep. Used to be a role model to all these geeks. Even gangsters looked up to you like when a respected father speaks. See, the problem is the hip hop, you are unique. That's why it also bothers me, because I feel like I'm putting my own dog to sleep. Watch it. Watching the karma seep, watching them burn alive from the inside as the karma seeps from your eyes onto your rotten cheeks. Cause the cannabis we used to know now is a shallow surface that's far from deep. And all that's left for you at the end is the nightmares that haunt your sleep, along with the psychological scars you keep as a product of the karma you gotten from fucking over all your peeps. So I don't give a fuck, homie, I get my G on. I'm a real MC, motherfuckers, I get my free on. So it makes sense that this motherfucker here has this little stupid sling on, cause he's never been a good shoulder to lean on.
Listen to me. The boy can spit, all right? I prepared for 3 weeks every day to come here. You understand me?
Right.
I wrote so many fucking rhymes, you can't memorize all that shit. I'm not a good freestyler, all right? I'm technical. Always been that way. And I didn't come here to let y'all down, all right? So this is what I'm gonna do. This is what I can't do no more than what I'ma do.
That's right.
So work with me. You win, Diz, alright? But I wanna still spit my shit. You understand me?
Go ahead.
You understand me?
Everybody shut up, listen to me.
I'ma just spit my shit from the top, the way that I was rehearsing it. You understand me?
No, spit that shit.
Heat it up, fresh goes. This is what you guys came here to see. Calm down. Let the man spit his lyrics.
Hey, yo! That's not what I would call Diz. See, Diz is something different. A faggot nigga trying to make a living off of this. He walk around spitting battle raps like he ill, but he can't avoid the fact. Yeah, you do got skills. 2012, I still spit that shit real niggas feel. Why does 99% of you resemble Mad Ills? Too late. Wipe that stupid look off your face. Straighten the height, looking like that Indian from Office Space.
Hold it down.
Disaster, just stop it. You're trying to battle on some pop. Shit. You weak, and you sound like Andy Milonakis. Hey, yo, brother. I'm just here to tell you that God loves all his creations except you. And after tonight, you battle rap for real. Then I'ma hop into the backseat of your cab and mob. What the fuck you looking at me for, Ali? Try.
Yo, Ellie, shut up. Listen to the man's lyrics. Come on, this is what you guys need to
hear. Yo, y'all don't want to hear the shit?
Yo,
yeah. All right. Y'all don't want to hear the shit. I stop. Y'all don't want to hear the shit. Put it in a thumb.
Hold up.
I rediscover hip-hop with my infinite rhyme. I'll even put the president back in office one more time. I charge Oprah's credit card and tell Barack to go long for another 90 yards. Motherfucker, I'm a hip-hop god. 20 years and I still got job. And I say if you want change, go wash them 16s out your drawers. You immature, fecal spore. Got the nerve to say you a beast with the bars. Don't you still live with your moms? That's right, dick in your mouth. Parents had to kick you out the house. After that, you moved in with your spouse. I can't tell if you a deadbeat dad or a red meat fag or a greasy ass nasty piece of Lebanese trash.
Yo! Yo, let me just end this fucking battle! If any more of this shit's gonna get postponed, this motherfucker's mad at me! Cause he's always getting his hoe boned! He said that I live at home with my parents! You're right, I'm 28 and I live in a crib that I don't own, but that makes me more qualified to smoke cannabis cause I've always been homegrown! Still be the best MC. Yeah. I'm just mad at you because I took all this time to prepare for you and you fucking disrespected me. You fucking disrespected me like you disrespected all. You disrespected Pharaoh Munch. You disrespected Wyclef. You hated on them all. Anybody doing more than you, you prayed and you waited on their fall. That's why he's speaking for me. I'ma say this for us all. That's why hip hop is forsaking you. And here you don't deserve a place at all. But in the restroom next to the toilet, hanging by the stall. But you don't even deserve to hang there either, cause I can still find more appreciation in the piss stains that are on the wall. Oh! You had a legendary cypher with DMX. Big Pun and Mos Def, my dude. Yeah, that shit is true. We seen it online. It got plenty of views. But the problem with that is that you said you deserved to go last out of all of them. What makes you think you're credible or even eligible to? Because 10 years have passed and the evidence proved that them three did more for hip-hop individually than you ever could do. So I don't want you to get mad. Let this just be a lesson to you. To act selfish in a cypher is something that's hella self-centered to do, but your cannabis, it's okay. You get a pass because it's expected from you. You think you're bigger than Pun? Pun is a legend, my dude. Yes. He's a worldwide icon, has sold more records, and he's more respected than you. You're just a homeless man on the corner holding a can, begging for food. Okay. Just accept that you're through. Accept that you will never accept it. Instead, you just do some extra reckless shit and just prove you'll always be a liability to anybody that's invested in you. Just ask Wyclef and tell you like the rest of them dudes. Your album flopped when it dropped, so you stabbed him in the back because you couldn't get it to move when you should have said thank you to you. He's the one that helped you improve. What's up, lady? Okay. Where you at, you pathetic Jew? Everyone that you, together you are like fucking tumors in the business that need to get removed. Everyone that you ever did business with to help you music and the end is getting sued, yourself included. What about all the efforts and attempts that you did to try to get us sued because some shit in the contract was left excluded? Wow. Yeah, don't believe nothing he's saying. If you do, then your head's polluted. This is why he's a disrespectful piece of shit and he's getting executed. I don't want to hear about how your presence helps the movement. It's more like an infection to it. You ain't here for us. You're here to fucking sell some units. How you gonna help us when you haven't even shown no sign of self-improvement? Just the same old pathetic underdeveloped human who never went through evolution. I mean this dude is stone age. Why try to relate with him? I should go on MySpace and find him a primate to go on a blind date with him, because at his mind state, that would be the prime mate for him. He's a Cro-Magnon man, a homo sapien, bipedal in shell with the brain missing. The way that he reacts, he has strange thinking to the way he displays rhythm. He's so ancient, I can't even communicate with him. It's like he has the most important strand of human DNA missing, so it has nothing to do with racism when I say I see the ape in him. With your fucking knowledge.
All right, man. I'll stab you. Let me go faster than you.
I'll stab you in your fucking eyes with a giant identical set of forks to Poseidon's. Or the type of forks that Lucifer pitches inside of the fires in hell that scorch. When I'm rhyming, I'm at the center core of a high-pressured reservoir of eternal fire that's strong enough to survive behind heaven's door. And if you stay alive, I'm gonna keep firing with a rifle like I'm trying to set the record store. Your body will show up at a fucking beach, some old dead. You can finally rest ashore. This motherfucker has spent his whole life on the message board. He's like a fuck, he's always on the net. This guy's like a tennis court. I mean, the creases above your eyes look like vinyl record warts. You look like some type of Kenyan dwarf collided with a virally infected I Am Legend corpse. Spliced with the fucking DNA of the alien from Splice or some other type of genetic source that was developed directly inside of the Umbrella Corp. It's like whatever. You killed the crowd, no one wants to even react no more. What you acting like a fucking faggot for? So I'ma end it with this last scheme. Everything that he did was totally fucking whack and it was overhyped. Homie, your fucking deposit for this battle was totally overpriced, but it's worth it knowing we could go home at night and sleep knowing some lunatic named Jermaine Williams doesn't own the rights. Cause if he did, he'd probably attach the footage to the back of a radioactive protocol device or something else that completely never existed, like his military soldier stripes. This motherfucker. Who gives a fuck if so-and-so sold their soul for ice? You're becoming more of an attention whore with every metaphor you write. This motherfucker's terrified of anyone who's 5'9 because it reminds him of Royce's height. Yo, when you're getting killed in a battle, you're supposed to fight. What are you, like 40, right? All you do is burn bridges like Usher. You're the corny type. You blackballed yourself into the horizon with Benzino riding with you on the back of the motorbike. Have you seen that tattoo on his arm? LL hates him, of course he's tight. This motherfucker couldn't beat him in a battle, so he turned around and literally stole his mic. So how the fuck are you gonna call J. Cole, J. Clone? How are you gonna call J. Cole, J. Clone, calling him a clone despite knowing that the only tattoo on your arm showing ain't even your own prototype? Say hello, good night. You wanna threaten LL and show up to the video with Mike, but we're all thinking, of course you roll with Mike. You and him are both alike, cause judging by that tattoo, both you faggots were born to bite. Yeah. But what are you gonna talk? How I choked and I didn't own them fucking moment, right? He probably mentioned some shit. He didn't, but fuck it, I'ma still own it, right? And yo, this motherfucker shouldn't be mad at me, cause I'm the one who helped him walk back towards the light. I'm the one who showed him what real hope is like. Yeah, I'm the one who gave him a chance after the industry already disowned him twice. They fucking left him. They controlled his life, so I don't give a fuck if I choked up in a battle and I froze that night. This cannabis over here fucking choked in life. You know your album is corny when you sound like a battle rapping valedictorian. Hold on. Alright, fuck it. No one wants to hear me anymore. So I'ma shoot through this fucking faggot. I'll pull out a bazooka and shoot him while he's moving through traffic. I'm an Islamic suicidal cuckoo fanatic. I'll put cannabis in a box and LL Cool J's a faggot. Yeah! Yeah!
Speaking of Doc Cannabis Disaster, yes. Make some fucking noise, y'all. Keep it down.
Guys, hold it down, hold it down, hold it down.
Hey, yo, I really did my best. I was unable to be up to snuff tonight. You know what I'm saying? The rhymes was there, but they wasn't locked in. You understand me? The shit happens. It can happen to anybody. You understand me? This. You ain't gotta look at me all tough no more. It's over.
I wanna tell you what I was thinking.
But Diz earned the title. He earned what he do.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? I wish y'all would have just, you know what I'm saying, let me do my shit my way and y'all would have listened, because there's some shit in there. But you know what I'm saying? It's y'all venue. Y'all came out, y'all handled it the way y'all want. But yo, make some motherfucking noise for Diz and KOTD, y'all.
I also have something to say, and I would love everybody to fucking listen. I would love everybody to listen to this. Yeah. Ever since I was a fucking young motherfucker when I first heard Cannabis, I knew this motherfucker was the best rapper in the world at the time. So at the end of the day, hold on, hold on, you ain't really hip-hop if there wasn't a point in your life where you heard this motherfucker and you were like, damn, I need to become like this motherfucker, I need to write like this. So at the end of the day, 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 time moves on, bro. We all move on, and you gotta pass the torch to somebody. I ain't gonna be here forever either, and the same shit's gonna happen. So right now, that's what's happening right here, bro. And that's all it is. Give them love, because nobody would have did this shit. Nobody would have had the balls to do this shit. Nobody. Thank you, man.
Hey, yo! He want the torch, he got it. Make some noise for Disaster, y'all.